This tutorial is part of our Building a Python Package course, where we learn how to build, test, and automate deployment of a Python Django middleware package to the Python package index. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other resources from our Udemy course. Now, alternatively, you can access the course via our YouTube playlist. This features tutorials from the course. Links to the YouTube course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. Having now started a new Django application, we're now ready to create a new app. So the app is going to be a separate component of our application, which is going to provide some sort of functionality to our application. If you remember in the first steps of creating a new Django project, we used Django admin command, and that allowed us to communicate with Django, if you like, to create a new Django project. Because we have now manage.py, because we've created a new project, we don't need to use it anymore. We can just use manage.py. And through that, we can now send commands to Django. So we now need to create a new app. So let's type in start app, and then let's give this a name, SQL query. That's the name of our app. Now this won't work, but I just wanted to show you this. So it says no such file or directory. Now, can you work out why that is? So you may have noticed that we're not in the virtual environment anymore. So we need to make sure that we're inside the virtual environment. So source VMV bin activate. This is on Mac, of course. And now I'm inside the virtual environment. So let's try this again. Manage.py start app and then SQL query. That's going to be the name of our app. And there we go. So our app is now created. It's a new folder, new set of files. So next up, we need to just go into the SQL middleware main directory here, and then select the settings here. And we just need to go in, just make sure that we register this application so that we can access resources within this application that we build. So installed apps. Let's add this in. So we're going to call this SQL query. That's the name of the app. And there we go. So whenever we create a new model, database tables inside of our new app here, Django will find this app, find the fact we've made those changes, and make the changes appropriately. Without this setting, Django won't know about this new app that we've just created.